the second Republic Day of India, the motherland. I'm sure all of you addressed by the Honorable President of India, Shri Ram Nath Kovind, on the eve of 72nd Republic Day of India. Dear fellow citizens, Namaskar. Greetings to all of you on the eve of 72nd Republic Day, the world's largest and most vibrant democracy. In this land of ours, enriched by diversity, with many festivals, our national festivals are celebrated by everyone with great patriotic fervor. We celebrate the national festival of the Republic Day with enthusiasm and express our respect for the national flag and our faith in the Constitution. This day has come to mean a lot to all Indians living within the country and abroad. 71 years ago, on this very day, we the people of India adopted, enacted and gave to ourselves a unique constitution for all of us, then this is a day to also pause and ponder over the core values that the constitution propounds. These values, justice, liberty, equality and fraternity outlined in the preamble of our constitution are sacred to all of us. Its ability, adherence is meant not only for those who are mandated to govern, but for the people at large. Chandra Bose inspired our freedom struggle. They had diverse dreams of a magnificent future of the motherland, but common to their aspiration were these values, justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. I would like that we go through back into history and inquire why precisely these values guided our nation builders. And the answer is obvious, that this land, its inhabitants have cherished these ideals from the time immemorial. Justice, liberty, equality and fraternity are the perennial principles of our philosophy of life. They come to us from the dawn of the civilization through an unbroken chain. It is of course the task of every generation to seek out the meaning of these values for its time. As the freedom fighters did in their day, so should we in our time. These key principles should light our path to development of humanity. Our scientists, along with doctors, administrators and people from other walks of life, have made major contribution in containing the virus and keeping the fatality rate lower in our country compared to that in developed countries. Thus, all our farmers, soldiers and scientists deserve special appreciation, and a grateful nation greets them on this auspicious occasion of the Republic Day. Dear fellow citizens, last year as humanity almost came to a halt in the face of calamity of gigantic proportions, I often found myself reflecting on the central message of the Constitution. Our effective response to the pandemic would not have been possible without our constitutional value of fraternity. Indians have been like a close-knit family, making exemplary sacrifices to protect each other in the face of common enemy of coronavirus. I am thinking here of doctors, nurses, paramedics, healthcare administrators and sanitation workers who put their own life at risk to care for COVID-19 patients. Some of them even lost their lives. Along with them, about 1.5 lakh people became victims of this pandemic. I convey my condolences to the bereaved families, our frontline corona warriors.
Thank you. जहाँ तेरी सदा मैं गीत वहाँ के गाता हूँ, भारत का रहने वाला हूँ, भारत की बात बताता हूँ।
Oh, yeah.